Hey friends, welcome back to eLearning Hub, your own learning partner. Today we are going to learn how to create an advanced Excel. In my previous video, I have already shown you how we can draw a basic Gantt chart using Excel sheet. If you have missed that video, just click on the link given below. You will be directed to that particular video. I have already explained the theories behind that, whatever theoretical stuff was there for Gantt chart and how to create a basic Gantt chart. I will not repeat all those things. You can just refer my previous video. We'll move further ahead from where I have left the previous video. In this particular video, I'll try to explain you how can we create a Gantt chart which will also have status of the activities. Like, you can see that for this I'm not going to take any particular example. Like in my previous video, I've taken example how to conduct a concert night and how to create a Gantt chart for that. In this, I've just taken a generic example. So if you can see that this particular video, this particular activity, this has been completed 50%, so it's been shaded in different color. So earlier we have just drawn a Gantt chart with the activities and the starting date and durations, but in this we'll be incorporating some extra thing, that's the status of all those activities that's there in the Gantt chart. So hope so you are clear with the agenda of this particular video, and we'll move forward from this. Once again, I will request, if you have not missed the first video, you just go through it. It will be better and easy for you to understand it. That's all I would like to request for. So I'll just open the sheet. So these are the activities that I have listed down. These are just generic names, task and subtask. And this plan activity is the overall activity that we need to complete. So before starting with the Gantt chart, what's the requirement? That we need to have the list of activities that need to be completed. That's already there in column A. Then start date of different activities, that's there in column B. Then either of duration or end date we need to have. Either we need to have the duration, that what will be the duration of this particular activity, or when it will be ending. So if you have end date, then you can just type start date and end date and just subtract. You will be getting the duration. You can see that B4 minus B4. So column D minus column B, you will be getting the duration for different activities. Or if you have readily the durations available, then no issue. Start date and duration, you need not to write end dates. So without wasting time, I'll just draw a Gantt chart. I'll not explain again how. You can just go through it while I'm drawing it. So just click outside. Just move this logo outside. Go to insert and draw a column chart, stacked one. Now one by one we'll add the data points to it. Select data, then add. Let's first of all add the start dates, that's the name of the series, and then the values are there. Okay, then we'll edit them because we have given some name, whatever, it's generic or something. Instead of getting 1, 2, 3, 8, it should get some name. Then again add duration for this, because either duration or end dates required to map the graph, that's why. Okay, so basic graph is created. Okay, but as I have already told you, you need to add few more things, like what's the status of the current project that you need to add. So I'll just put this graph aside and we'll work on it later. First, for that we need to do some backend activity that we need to cover it here. So I have the duration. So if in case I want to plot status, I need the current. So for that I will just take input of status. What is the status of the activity, that particular activity, and then I will insert two columns where there. Then one will be that completion. We'll have to calculate something like how much work has been completed, and then pending. Then completion is the part, whatever status is given, that's the completion. So I'll just convert this as a percentage. That's it's a percentage 10a. We don't need any decimal space place over there. So completion equal to status multiplied by duration. This is completion. And what's pending is equal to duration minus what's completed. Just enter. Just copy down this formula for complete chart. Then we are done. This Gantt chart that we have created is a basic chart that already we have seen. Now instead of this, we need some other things like completion and pending status. So we'll just change it. I'll draw a new chart. That will be better. Instead of editing and changing, it will be getting confused. I'll just delete this. Now just click outside, go to insert, go to column charts, and then draw a standard column chart. Then I'll just go to right click and go to select data. Now I will add start dates, the values it's written over there in this range. I'll just select them. So it's done. Now I will edit their axis labels, although generic name, but we have given something, so we'll add it. Okay, now instead of adding directly duration, it will give me the overall Gantt chart. I will add another cell, that's the completion, so that we can shade them in other colors. And then we'll add one more, that's the pending, so that we can shade them in some other colors, so that it will be giving us the output that's required by us. Then just okay, we've got some rough Gantt chart with us. Okay, we'll try to edit and make it more feasible. So first of all, we need to change this orientation, because plant is in last and subtask 5.1 is in first top. That's the reverse actually. So just click this axis labels and just format axis will. Then in this format axis option, we'll go and put this categories in reverse order. So it's done now. Again, we'll start dates need to be eliminated. Since we have not put any status over there, we are not getting completion graph in this. Well, so I'll just put some random numbers. 50% completed, 50% completed, 45% completed, 80% completed, 10% completed. Just to give some random number, it might be that this event cannot complete 80%. If it's 50%, none of the activities can be more than 50%. Something like that can be there, but I'm just giving some random numbers so that just to edit this chart. So one thing is done, that categories are taken in correct order. Now I'll remove this. Fill, make it as no fill. Then I need to edit this axis also, because in order to edit this axis, just go to the first date and right click and format cell, find the general number for this 42644. Just edit this, minimum number should be 42644. So that's done. So somewhat it started looking like a Gantt chart now. Now I will edit this. I'll make it more wide so that this width needs to be reduced. So now again, what we can do is we can make it parallel to this, so it will be better. all the main tasks we can put in some other colors and some other tasks in some other color. That all depends upon how much you want to do the formatting so as to make it look good. So completion will put in some other type, some shaded types. Pattern field will put some patterns. We'll edit this and we'll put some good colors. So this is our Gantt chart. Let me just focus on this now. Out of this, if this is, it's up to you, whatever color and whatever texture and however you want to put like that, it's up totally up to you. Now main thing was that I wanted to introduce something known as the status, like this particular activity is completed this much. That's the thing that we wanted to incorporate. So I'll just put the labels over there so that it will be good. I'll just change their font color because it's not visible there. Now you can put add labels with these also. So now overall activity 25 days works. 25 days work is completed and more 25 days need to be completed. This is what we can see from this particular Gantt chart. Earlier it was like complete 50 days were given, but what's the status of the project, that was not clear. So from this particular video you can directly say, yeah, it's more 25 days will be required to complete this activity. So I'll just put some random numbers in order to fill this. So here is the graph that you have prepared. It's called Excel Gantt chart along with the status. So hope so you got some idea about how you can create a Gantt chart with some status. So once it's done, you can reduce their width instead of hiding, because then chart will not be able to read the value. So next time what you need to do, just put the status over there whenever there is any change, and your graph will be automatically updated accordingly. So you can use this graph directly for your presentation and anything like that. Hope so you got some idea what's the thing that we tried, that I wanted to convey. And if you like this particular video, just subscribe the channel so you'll be getting latest updates from our side. Whenever the any video is posted, you will be getting a real notice on your mailboxes. So till then, thank you.